All right, so in this kit, we've also provided an inventory system. Let's take a look at the inventory system now. If we select Ellen and scroll all the way down in the inspector, we have an inventory controller, and this controls what Ellen can collect. So we can see that she has several keys that she can collect, and she's already holding a staff and a gun. So these are already set up for the way that they're set up for the game. So in the game example, you can collect 3 keys to open a door and eventually collect a staff and a gun. So I'm going to just quickly, with Ellen selected, I'm going to control click on cameras and move Ellen to this top area here, just so I can quickly test that game design that I'm going to show you now. So let's add a key into this environment. So I'm going to click and drag from the interactables folder in the project window and add the key. So now that we have the key added in, it's just an object. If we look at the inspector, there's nothing special about it. It's just set up as a regular object. If we press play and just run into it, nothing will happen. It's just an object. It has a nice floating animation, and that's about it. To make sure that Ellen's inventory controller expects this key to be collected, we need to make the key an inventory item. And the way we do this is with the key selected in the hierarchy, in the inspector, let's click on add component and start typing in inventory, if I'd spelt it right, inventory. And here we can see the inventory controller, an inventory item. So I want the inventory item because it is an item for the inventory. Now we can see this big green circle that's sort of surrounding the key. This is actually the key's collider. So when Ellen walks into this area, that's how we know that she's walked into it and can collect it. This is very large right now. It's not the size of the key, so I want to make it the size of the key. In the inspector, on the circle collider 2D, I can select this radius option and click and drag this down a bit, so it's about the size, I think that'll do, about the size of the key. There we go. So the inventory item has this inventory key. Now, let's not get confused with this being a key. This isn't the same as the object. This is expecting a unique identifier, so a specific word that we set up for Ellen's inventory to recognize the object. So let's take a look at Ellen and see what she expects. So if we click on Ellen in the hierarchy, scroll down again to the inventory controller, we can see here that in the sections we have key one and then the word key here, and this key one should match. If I change this to key, it also changes what it is in here, but I want to keep it at key one. So again, this is the unique identifier that we set for it to recognize an object with the same name. So if we go to staff, the staff also has a unique identifier, and that's staff. And so we want to make sure that the physical key that we have in the scene has the same unique identifier of key one. So let's go back to the key game object. And in the inventory key, I'm going to type in key one. Here we go. And right now it's got another layers option. So anything can collect this. Anything that has an inventory controller can collect this, which isn't what we want. So imagine if we put an inventory controller on a chomper and it walked past, it would be able to collect the key, which is definitely not what we want. We want to have the key. So if I select nothing to clear all the selections and then select the player, then Ellen will be able to collect it. However, if we play, nothing happens. So I think this is being collected in her inventory, but I don't actually know that for a fact. There's no feedback here for the player. So I'm going to exit play mode and trigger some events that happen. The first thing I'm going to do is trigger a sound. So triggering a sound for this is slightly different than earlier. If it's an inventory item, there's a clip option here, which is expecting an audio clip. And we can find audio clips in the project view. And if we go to expand the audio and the interactables folder, these are all the audio clips associated with interactables. And what I want is, there's no single one for a key specifically, but there is a generic pickup sound. So I'm going to click and drag this in. And now when I press play, when I collect this, it should play that generic pickup sound. So let's connect this to something actually happening when we've collected it in the inventory. So usually the stereotypical thing is collecting a key to open a door. So that's what we're going to do. I'm going to exit play mode. And I'm going to grab a door from the interactables folder. And I'm going to put it just next to it, just so we can see. Now, right now, just as before with the pressure pad, when we walk over and collect this, we can hear the sound, but the door doesn't open. So I'm going to exit play mode and look at Ellen's inventory controller again. I'm going to scroll down right to the bottom. And here is the event when key one is added. So on add, I'm going to press the plus button to add something to the list. And I'm going to drag the door into the empty slot. And just like before with the pressure pad, I'm going to find the animator section and the play string function. And in that, I'm going to type in door opening again. And now when I collect the key, when it lands in her inventory, it should trigger that in animation. So collect the key, and now it's opening the door. So we just need to do one last thing to indicate that the key has been collected. You'll notice that when we actually run into it, it doesn't disappear. And a good indication to the player that it's been collected, other than an action happening, is if the key doesn't appear anymore. So let's select the key. And in its inventory item, we have an option to disable on enter. And this will turn off the object as soon as you walk into it and collect it. So if I press play now, when I walk into it, it's going to disappear. And that looks a bit better for the player, so they know that they've actually collected the key. But if I was to have this door somewhere else in my level and my key somewhere else in my level, there's another thing we can do just to indicate to the player that we have the key still collected. We can do this with adding some UI. So I'm going to exit play mode. And in the project window, still in the prefabs folder, we have UI prefabs. And these are a bunch of UI elements that we've already set up. And what we're looking for is the key canvas. Don't get confused with the key icon, that's just an individual icon. We want a canvas to display over our screen. So I'm going to click and drag this key canvas into the UI section in the hierarchy. Now this sectioning doesn't actually affect anything, it's just so we can keep things nice and tidy if we end up having a fairly large level with a lot of objects, we can quickly find what we need. Now if I press play, I have these sort of empty slots on the top right. And if I walk into the key now, it automatically detects that a key has been collected. The way it does this is by using that same unique identifier that the inventory does. So if we look at the key canvas in the inspector, we have a key UI component here, and we have key names. So here we've got some separate elements. So this is just a bucket of options that it's kind of looking for. So here we've got key one, and when key one is collected, it will display that changed icon. We also have, since we have an example game with three keys to collect, we've got key two and key three. We can actually remove these and stop them from displaying for this level. The way to do that is where it says element one, we're going to right click and delete array element. And then on element one again, this just moves up the list. We're going to delete array element. And now we're just left with one key that it's expecting. So if I press play now, we should have one icon in the top right. And when we collect it, that one icon will be filled.